Behind the Score, the inside stories from Hollywood's greatest filmmakers and composers.
One of the things unique to big cities, and Los Angeles in particular, is the use of billboards to advertise upcoming movies. On any given day, you might see 25 billboards for different films and TV shows. While driving from the Valley, where the Universal, Disney, and Warner Brothers studio lots are, to Culver City and Sony Pictures, or Century City and Fox Studios. It's an industry town, which means, unlike other cities, it makes a lot of sense to advertise on good old-fashioned billboards.
It can be kind of disconcerting.
That's composer Trevor Rabin, known for his scores to Remember the Titans, Con Air, and Enemy of the State.
The billboards are sometimes up before you've literally before you've started writing the music. And not only are they up, but the release date is there.
You spend about a day or two panicking more and thinking that you're never going to get it done.
Composer Lorne Balfe of The Crown and this summer's upcoming blockbuster Mission Impossible Fallout says sometimes the easiest thing to do is not look at the billboards.
So you're stuck inside, and then when you do go out, it's probably to get on the plane to go to London, and then you see the commercial. I think 10 years ago, I used to panic and worry about deadlines, the whole structure of things. And now I don't, because if I do, I'm not focusing on music.
Blocking out billboards, a strategy Rabin's used too.
You do see the billboards up, certainly before you finish doing the film, and with a release date there, and you drive past it thinking, I don't want to look at that billboard because I'm just about to go home to start writing the music.
It is kind of exciting when you see billboards and things are becoming real.
Composer Bear McCreary of The Walking Dead, Outlander, 10 Cloverfield Lane, and The Cloverfield Paradox says he prefers to be finished scoring by the time the ad campaigns begin.
Sometimes it's the inverse, where I'll be pencils down on a show and then like 3 or 4 months later, it's announced. And then you see a first billboard and people go, dude, have you heard about this show Black Sails? It's like pirates, that's cool. And I'm like, yeah, it's gonna be cool. I not only did it, I finished it already. And I've just been waiting for people to know what it is. Like, it's actually kind of exciting for me. Like, people are gonna get to hear it. We're almost at the point where it becomes real.
For more stories behind the score, read Score, The Interviews, based on the international hit film Score, a film music documentary featuring raw insight from Hans Zimmer, James Cameron, Quincy Jones, Randy Newman, Trent Reznor, and many more. Score, The Interviews, available now at score-movie.com.